Let's go back and try to work this one out. So we have 1 over O plus 1 over I equals 1 over F. And we're going to set I equal to minus F. So 1 over O minus 1 over F equals 1 over F. Or 1 over O equals 2 over F. Or O equals F over 2. F is 20 centimeters, so that's 10 centimeters is the correct answer. And again, rather than shoving numbers in right away, do it algebraically. Save yourself time and trouble. Let's see how you did. Most of you chose B, good. And some of you somehow got E, 40 centimeters, but it could just be an algebraic thing. Very good. This summarizes the sign conventions. This is definitely one of the little tables and pictures you should have in your cheat, your growing cheat sheet, right? So we have our thin lens equation, and we have our object, the front of the lens, the back of the lens, and then in this case the image. It's not drawn completely to scale given these numbers here. But if we have F, the focal length, if it's positive, that means we have a converging lens. If it's negative, it's a diverging lens, as we saw. We haven't talked much about images from diverging lenses, but they work too. O, if it's positive, that means it's in front of the lens. And if it's negative, it's behind the lens. And you might think, why would you ever want the object behind the lens? Because the light needs to go into the front of the lens, not behind it. Well, it turns out that if you have two lenses, you'd use the thin lens equation twice, only for the second lens, the object can be a virtual object, which is the image of the first lens. The image of the first lens becomes the object for the second lens, is the way you would work it out. So we retain this possibility. You will not use this possibility, I don't believe, in the DLs or any problems that we'll give you. And then, lastly, the image, if it's positive, it's behind the lens. That means it's over here on this side of the lens. And as we have already seen, the image doesn't have to be on either side of the lens necessarily. If I is negative, it's in front of the lens. Now, in one of these cases, the image is real for a single lens, and in another case, it's virtual. So in which case is it real, in which case is it virtual? Let's see. If the image is behind the lens, that means it's over here, is it a real or a virtual image? I'm hearing both. Who thinks real? Who thinks virtual? It's a real image. There's really light coming from that place. If it's in front of the lens, it's a virtual image. And light is not really coming from that place in space. Okay? So you're going to have to go back through that. I think you have to break those false impressions that you've got about real and virtual images. And you'll think about it more in DL. Now, what about magnification? As we can see with Ernie, the size of the image can be different depending on where Ernie is with respect to the lens. So we define something called the magnification, which is the ratio of the height of the image to the height of the object. And again, we could derive it, but we are just declaring that the magnification ends up being minus I over O for a thin lens, using the thin lens equation. Now, if M turns out to be greater than 0, that means HI over HO is greater than 0, meaning it's positive. That means the image is right side up, it's erect. If M is less than 0, it's inverted. So we can either have an erect or an inverted image, depending on how the lens and the object are arranged. The other thing that we care about is the magnitude of M. If the magnitude of m is greater than 1, the image is larger than the object, because the height of the image is greater than the height of the object. And the magnitude of h is greater than the magnitude of hi, is greater than the magnitude of ho. All right. And if m is less than 1, magnitude absolute value is less than 1, the image is smaller than the object. And I think we saw that when we placed Ernie close here, we had a pretty big image, right? Where'd it go? That's worse. I think he's in there somewhere. Anyway, he's kind of big. The size of the image is much bigger than the actual object. So that's what we mean by magnification mathematically. Now, does that mean the image, if we have a magnification bigger than 1, does that mean the image looks bigger? Is it really a magnifying glass? So you shouldn't confuse the magnification of the image with the apparent angular size. It only looks bigger to you if it has a bigger angle relative to your eye, right? Now, consider an object here like we had before, half a focal length away from this lens. The image that is created is twice as large. And so if your eye is here, if you didn't have the lens here, the object would look this big. But as soon as you put the lens there in front of the object, between the object and your eye, it looks bigger. It has a bigger angular size. Contrast that with this situation. In this case, magnitude of m is less than 1. But with the object out here, you know, it would look smaller to your eye because it's much farther away. The object is really farther away than the image. The image is close. Even though the image is close and small, it looks bigger to your eye. So, in fact, when you look through binoculars or a telescope at a distant object, it looks bigger to you, or it looks closer, right, because it has a bigger angular size, even though the actual image is quite small inside the binoculars or telescope. All right? So you're going to need to think about this effect as well, though you will not be calculating the apparent angular size. That's a much more complicated. You won't be calculating the angular magnification because that's a much more complicated thing to do. But why don't we do another clicker question here? This is a tough one, so I'll give you plenty of time. So we have a convex lens with f greater than 0. And in order to have an upright, that is, erect image for O greater than 0, which means the object is on the correct side of the lens, which of the following things has to be true? Object must be a distance f from the lens, objects must be further than f from the lens, the object must be a distance less than f from the lens. So work together. You need to do a little bit of algebra to do this one using the thin lens equation and the definition of magnification.